everyone. Hope you all are doing good. So I'm Ruchira and we're back with the second season of Conversing with the Common Man, and I welcome you all in our second episode of new season. So as you all know, to celebrate the 100th birth anniversary of our beloved RK Lakshman, we are hosting so many programs and conversations from this platform. And in this particular program called Conversing with the Common Man, we are bringing people and experts who were close and associated with RK Lakshman in various ways. We had so many interesting speakers and we unfolded a lot many stories in front of you. They didn't only talk about their association but also enlightened us about their faith. It's overwhelming, isn't it? If you have missed anything or our previous sessions, then that's okay because you can go and watch them on our YouTube channel, but not now, because now we are here to celebrate the curtain raiser of this month. So this month we are going to celebrate all these other aspects of the personality and RK Lakshman, that is the storyteller, the writer and the director side of the RK Lakshman. So whenever we remember him and his common man, we can't forget his Bangle Ki Duniya and what contribution he has done in that industry and in that field. So in the light of revival of Bangle Ki Duniya, today we will be talking about him as a writer, as a director, as a visualizer, as a storyteller, and we will revisit some memories from the time of original Bangle Ki Duniya. Today, along with Usha Aunty, we have Nandu Gupta with us, who is also going to share lots of stories about this show and his association with Lakshman family. So without taking more time, I invite Usha Aunty to introduce Nandu Uncle and today's curtain raiser.
Thank you, Ruchira. Yes, I agree with you. It is a very emotional evening for all of us. As a curtain raiser, before the Bangle Ki Duniya serial that is going to start from tomorrow. And in light of this, I take pleasure in introducing Nandu Gupta, who is a very, very close family friend of ours and also closely associated with all the works of the initiative that we are doing based on Lakshman's works. And he is also the director of Common Man Works Private Limited. And in his own capacity, he is the joint managing director heading agro division of Indore Mines Limited, which is a listed company. And so he is here with us to share various anecdotes and, you know, remembering Lakshman and his association with him. And also about the journey of Bangle Ki Duniya from when it started and where we are now. So before I go ahead, I would like to, remember and feel really emotional about the 100th birth anniversary. This particular initiative that we are undertaking in the month of February, where we are dedicating this month for Bangle Ki Duniya, which is a very, very close passion which Dad enjoyed immensely every single minute of it. And it gives me immense pleasure to remember all of that and share that with all of you. And of course, yes, our Dad Lakshman's talent and interest extended beyond cartoons and caricature. So yes, over to you, Ruchira.
Thank you so much, Nandu अंकल, आई वुड लाइक टू आस्क, मुझे आपको पहला सवाल पूछना है कि क्योंकि आपके फैमिली लक्ष्मण फैमिली के साथ काफी सालों से जुड़ी हुई है, तो क्या आपके इस एसोसिएशन के बारे में और अगर लक्ष्मण सर के साथ अगर आपके कुछ फेवरेट एनेक्डोट्स होंगे आपके मीटिंग्स में से, अगर वो आप हमारे साथ शेयर कर सके तो हमें बहुत अच्छा लगेगा.
हाय ऑल, एंड आई एम रियली ग्रेटफुल दैट you have invited me to this show. और ये miracle man का legacy है, क्योंकि अभी तक कोई भी ऐसा miracle man पैदा नहीं हुआ है. और मैं बहुत खुशगुजार हूँ कि I am the part of it. और मुझे एक मौका मिला है कि उनकी legacy को आगे ले जाने का. और मेरा जो भी paraphernalia है, जैसे मेरे कलीग्स हैं, मेरे सब एसोसिएट्स हैं, तो उन सब को जो है मैं इकट्ठा करके और उषा जी को मैं सपोर्ट कर रहा हूँ एंड इसमें मुझे बहुत खुशी है कि एक लेजेंड को जो है हम लोग उनकी लेगेसी को आगे ले जाने की कोशिश कर रहे हैं। और वैसे मैं लक्ष्मण साहब को बहुत करीबी से जानता था और उनका जो वे ऑफ वर्किंग था वो बिल्कुल स्ट्रेट फॉरवर्ड था और वो मुंहफट थे बिल्कुल। वो ऊपर से एकदम कड़क थे लेकिन अंदर से बिल्कुल सॉफ्ट और एकदम पैशनेट इंसान थे। तो वो किसी को भी, और लोग बार बहुत डरते थे उनसे, तो उनके पास जाने के पहले वो 10 बार सोचते थे कि भाई कैसे जाएं और कैसे प्रेजेंट करें। रुचिरा, देर इज सम मैसेज थिंग कमिंग विच आई कांट सी माय स्क्रीन फुल्ली, आई डोंट नो
व्हाट इज जस्ट अ प्राइवेट चैट बिटवीन अस टू।
अच्छा अच्छा, नहीं तो उसे हटा सकते हो क्या? क्योंकि वो मैं अपने आप को नहीं देख पा रहा हूँ।
ओह दैट्स बिकॉज़ योर स्क्रीन इज स्मॉल।
अच्छा ऐसा है, तो ये
फुल स्क्रीन, वी कैन सी यू
इस तरफ आता हूँ तो ठीक है। तो उनके साथ मेरे बहुत अच्छे एक्सपीरियंसेस हैं और मुझे उन्होंने बहुत हेल्प किया है इन सेंस की इन माय आई एम अ केमिकल मैन्युफैक्चरिंग में हूँ और कभी कभार जब कोई प्रॉब्लम आती थी मैं उनके पास जाता था। तो जैसे एक एग्जांपल बताऊँ, एक बार कोई पोल्यूशन वाला हमारे यहाँ आया था और वो करीब वो मतलब थोड़ा अनरीजनेबल चीज़ें कर रहा था, वी वेर इन द लॉ बट ही मेड सम पर्टिकुलर रिपोर्ट और समथिंग विच वॉज नॉट इन फेवर ऑफ अवर कंपनी। तो मैं उनके पास गया और मैं बोला कि वो बोल पूछे कि भाई क्या हुआ, तो मैंने बताया उनको, तो उन्होंने सीधा फ़ोन उठा के एनवायरनमेंट मिनिस्टर को ही फ़ोन लगा दिया और उनको बोलने लगे भाई ये मेरा जो लड़का है ये लॉ बाइंडिंग आदमी है, इसको कौन तुम्हारा पोल्यूशन वाला कुछ सता रहा है। तो 10 मिनट के अंदर वो आदमी का फ़ोन आ गया, वो बोला भैया आपका परिचय दो। मैं बोला भाई मैंने तो तुमको कार्ड दे दिया, सब कुछ दे दिया। नहीं, बोला आप किसको जानते हो? मैं बोला भैया मैं तो लॉ को जानता हूँ, मैंने तो कुछ ऑफ लॉ किया नहीं है। तो कहने का क्या मतलब है, ही वॉज सो फेमस, ही वॉज यू नो इन ईच एंड एवरी पर्सन्स माइंड। तो मुझे काफ़ी मतलब फ़ायदा है और ये मैं जो भी उनके लिए कर रहा हूँ वो एक ट्रिब्यूट है कि भाई उन्होंने जो मेरे लिए किया तो मैं उनके लिए अभी करूँ। सो दैट इज़ हाउ आई एम एसोसिएटेड एंड आई एम यू नो ट्राइंग टू डू माई बेस्ट टू सी दैट हिज लेगेसी इज टेकन फॉरवर्ड एंड यू नो द यंगर जनरेशन नोज अबाउट हिम। And that is how exactly this Vaghle ki duniya, we got it on the track and we got it on stream. And fortunately, it has all happened in a matter of 5 days. And we were able to do this thing. And God willing, this will be one of the best show because it depicts the common man grievances. बिकॉज लक्ष्मण साहब की पूरी लाइफ कॉमन मैन में रिवॉल्व करती थी, इट यूज टू रिवॉल्व विद द कॉमन मैन एंड हिज ईच ब्रेथ वॉज फॉर द कॉमन मैन एंड फॉर द बेटरमेंट ऑफ द कॉमन मैन। जैसा वो बोलते थे कि मेरा अल्ट्रा ईगो है कॉमन मैन और इसने मुझे ढूंढा है तो मुझे इसके लिए कुछ करना चाहिए। तो द वागले की दुनिया वॉज द मीडिया हाउ ही वॉन्टेड टू टेल द ग्रीवियंसिस ऑफ द कॉमन मैन मे बी टू द एडमिनिस्ट्रेशन सो दैट दे कैन टेक अप्रोप्रिएट स्टेप्स सो दैट द कॉमन मैन इज कम्फर्टेबल। सो द सीरियल इज फॉर द कॉमन मैन ऑफ इंडिया एंड फॉर देयर बेटरमेंट। and I am very happy that we are a part of it. Over to you, Ruchira.
थैंक यू सो मच अंकल. सो नाउ बिकॉज अंकल ने भी अभी बांग्ला की दुनिया मेंशन करी है, सो आई वुड लाइक टू आस्क उषा आंटी, हाउ डिड इट ऑल स्टार्टेड दैट टाइम एंड वी वांट टू नो द स्टोरी बिहाइंड बांग्ला की दुनिया.
दैट्स रियली वेरी इंटरेस्टिंग. एवरीवन मस्ट हैव हर्ड ऑफ दुर्गा कोटे, फेमस एक्ट्रेस. सो दुर्गा कोटे'स डॉटर-इन-लॉ इज हीना कोटे. And they had a production house called Durga Kote Productions. So once in one of the parties, Hina Kote, when she met Dad, she asked, why not we bring your daily cartoons onto the TV platform? So he said, why, what is it that you want on the TV? I mean, I cannot bring my cartoons onto the TV platform. The concept can be for the common man, but not the cartoons cannot be reproduced because my common man does not speak. But I will do something completely individual, conceptualized, everything fresh. Because Dad always believed in doing things fresh. Because when there is an idea, his idea is always fresh. He never liked to do the copy-paste business or never liked to, do something which is existing and modulate them for something else. So he believed in every time creating something new. So he said, what is that you want? I will create it and I'll give it to you. That is how it all started. So Vagle Ki Duniya original was conceptualized, devised and created for the National Doordarshan as a TV serial, which used to appear once a week, prime time, 9 p.m. And of course, it started with 6 episodes to begin with. And that's the way it all started.
थैंक यू सो मच आंटी. सो अंकल, मुझे आपसे वापस एक सवाल पूछना है कि ये जो कॉमन मैन वागले की दुनिया में कैप्चर करा था, तो उसके बारे में, उस एक्सपीरियंस के बारे में आप क्या कहना चाहोगे?
देखिए, ये जो कुंदन शाह थे, उन्होंने इनको बोला कि भाई आप रोज एक नई स्टोरी लिखते हो और एक इतनी छोटी सी फ्रेम में आप पूरी स्टोरी लिख देते हो और उसमें कॉमन मैन है, तो अगर आप एक सीरियल बनाएंगे या लिखेंगे तो उसमें एकदम ओरिजिनलिटी होगी और वो सीरियल कुछ मतलब मैसेज दे पाएगा. जैसे आप मैसेज आपके कार्टून के थ्रू देते हो, तो सीरियल के थ्रू वो मैसेज जो है एक थोड़ा और इफेक्टिव होगा. तो उनको ये आइडिया, ही लाइक द आइडिया और उन्होंने बोला ठीक है मैं करूँगा. और उन्होंने उनको लोग बार कार्टूनिस्ट की तरह जानते हैं, बट ही वॉज अ वेरी वेरी गुड एक्टर. उनकी एक्टिंग मैंने तो देखी है. और जब उन्होंने ये सीरियल का मतलब ही डिसाइडेड टू डू दिस सीरियल, तो वो पूरा सीरियल इनेक्ट करके बताते थे एक्टर्स को. और वो एक्टर्स बोलते थे कि भाई उन्होंने पूरा सीरियल 10 मिनट में हमारे सामने खड़ा कर दिया. मतलब वो बोलते थे कि भाई ये इसका फोकस है, ये इसको तुम्हें कन्वे करना है और इसमें आपको. और उनकी एक और बात थी कि वो कभी भी ओवर एक्टिंग नहीं लाइक करते थे. अंजन साहब ने उनको बताया कि भाई मैं कैसे एक्ट करूं, तो उन्होंने बोला देखो जैसे तुम घर पे रहते हो ना, घर पे बीवी से बात करते हो, घर पे जैसे डरते हो बीवी से, बच्चों से डरते हो, वैसे ही तुम एक्ट करो, एकदम नेचुरल करो जैसे तुम घर पे करते हो. तो उस हिसाब से उन्होंने जो ये सीरियल की जो डायरेक्शन किया है वो बिल्कुल अलग था रेगुलर लोगों से. और उसमें जो है एकदम जो रियल स्टोरी होती है वो रियल स्टोरी दिखाई देती थी. तो उस हिसाब से उन्होंने ये मतलब एक्सेप्ट किया बिकॉज इट वॉज फॉर द कॉमन मैन. नहीं तो वो और कोई सीरियल उन्होंने लिखा नहीं, बट क्योंकि ये कॉमन मैन के लिए सीरियल था उन्होंने एक्सेप्ट किया. और उनको ये आइडिया भी पसंद आया एंड देट इज हाउ the entire Wagle ki duniya was made.
Yes. So, Usha aunty, because uncle just mentioned Anjan Srivastav sir also, so would you like to introduce Anjan sir, the original Wagle and
Sure. Before I go on to Anjan and Bharti ji, when Wagle ki duniya was shown, I'm talking about in the late 80s when it started. So millions of viewers across the country watching the TV serial Wagle ki Duniya. And if you remember, maybe you youngsters may not remember, were not even born.
No.
That time even Mahabharat used to be screened every Sunday. And the street used to be in pin drop silence. And it was the same scenario even when Wagle ki Duniya was shown at 9 p.m. in the night. There was, not a soul would be on the road. Everybody would be watching it in their drawing room. That was the kind of sensation it created, and it became a habit and an enforcing thing. As just as people used to, read his news edit every morning. That's the way they used to wait for his once a week Wagle ki Duniya episode. And about Anjan Srivastava, amongst hundreds of people. In the audition, he decided that as far as caste is concerned, these are the conditions that he gave to Tina Kote, that I would conceptualize the whole thing, I will create, I will devise, and the main caste would be chosen by me, because the characterization and the thought process of the story is all from me. So I know exactly how a character should be and should fit in the role. And so amongst hundreds of the audience, and there were people who were even better known than Anjan, who were there, but out of all of that, he chose Anjan Srivastava. So Anjan ji is eternally grateful to that. I don't have to talk about it. If you listen to his video, you will understand exactly how he feels, and he's spoken from his heart. And so is Bharti ji. So viewers, I would like you all to listen to this heart warming video that has come from the heart of Anjan ji and Bharti ji.
Namaskar. मैं हूं अंजन श्रीवास्तव उर्फ वागले, यही नाम है मेरा, अंजन वागले श्रीवास्तव। करीब 20 साल तक यही नाम चला, फिर धीरे धीरे अंजन श्रीवास्तव को लोग जानने लगे कि अंजन श्रीवास्तव अलग है और वागले अलग है। आप लोगों से मैं मुखातिब हूं आज श्रद्धेय श्री आर के लक्ष्मण जी का शतवार्षिकी सेंटिनरी मनाया जा रहा है। मैं उनको नमन करता हूं और ये बताना चाहता हूं कि मैं उनका बहुत शुक्रगुजार हूं, इतना कि मैं शब्दों पे नहीं कह सकता। दरअसल जो कुछ भी हूं आज, चाहे फिल्मों में, टेलीविजन में, चाहे वेब सीरीज में, मुझे आज भी लोग वागले के नाम से ही जानते हैं। मैंने बहुत कोशिश की, लेकिन आर के लक्ष्मण साहब ने जो नाम दे दिया, वो नाम मेरी जिंदगी के आखिरी वक्त तक चलेगा। मुझे याद है वो दिन जब उन्होंने मुझे चुना था इस रोल के लिए, और किस तरह से उन्होंने मुझे धीरे 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 इस कैरेक्टर में ढाला। इसमें कुंदन शाह जी और रवि ओझा और आर के लक्ष्मण, जैसे लगता है कि एक टीम, एक बटालियन आ गई मेरे पीछे जो मुझे वागले बना के छोड़ेगी, और वो किया उन लोगों ने। और ऐसा वागले जमा कि वो वागले हर चरित्र में, सिनेमा के कई चरित्रों में लोगों ने मुझे वागले की तरह मांगा कि भाई, यही डिमांड हुई कि मुझे वागले चाहिए। आज 32 साल के बाद, जब मैं काफी बूढ़ा हो गया हूं, तो आज भी देखिए वागले की क्या डिमांड है। आज फिर से वागले की दुनिया बन रही है, पर इसका श्रेय सब टीवी सोनी सबको, और सबसे पहले जेडी मजीठिया को जाती है, आतिश कपाड़िया को जाती है। इतना बड़ा जोखिम, इतनी हिम्मत जो उन्होंने दिखाई है, क्योंकि वागले सबके बस की बात नहीं है, पर इन्होंने कोशिश तो की। ये मुझे और भारतीय अचरेकर, यानी वागले और राधिका, श्रीनिवास वागले, राधिका वागले, दोनों को लेके एक नए परिवार में, एक नई पीढ़ी के साथ चल रहे हैं। अब ये नई पीढ़ी कौन है? मेरा छोटा बेटा मनोज नहीं, राजू, दो बेटे थे हमारे, जब आर के लक्ष्मण साहब थे। अब वो राजू बड़ा हो गया है, राजू की जिंदगी दिखा रहे हैं। अब राजू वो अगले परिवार के उस वैल्यूज को लेके कैसे चलता है, वो इसी सेट पर हम लोग अगले की दुनिया, नई पीढ़ी, नए किस्से के साथ आपके सामने हाजिर होंगे। उम्मीद करता हूँ कि आप सबको पसंद आएगा, क्योंकि उस समय की छोटी छोटी बातें जो थी वो आज की इस जमाने की छोटी छोटी बातों को लेके ये सीरियल बना है। हर एपिसोड एक नई कहानी है, एक नए किरदार कुछ आते हैं, पर वैसे ये समाज सोसाइटी भी है, वॉचमैन है, मैं हूँ, राजेश वागले यानी राजू, राधिका है, बहू है, बच्चे हैं यानी पोते हैं, पोतियां हैं, और आज वही कॉमन मैन इन सब लोगों को लेके, इन सब सराउंडिंग्स को लेके कैसे आज की जिंदगी बसर कर रहा है, इसकी एक झांकी शायद आपको इस नए वागले में मिले। इसे जरूर देखें और फिर से एक बार श्री आर के लक्ष्मण को याद करें, जो हमेशा एवरग्रीन है, उनकी सब्जेक्ट एवरग्रीन है। इतने बड़े जर्नलिस्ट, इतने बड़े मूर्तिकार, इतने बड़े कार्टूनिस्ट और इतने बड़े फिल्मकार, उन्होंने साबित कर दिया कि हिंदुस्तान में सीरियल या फिल्म किस तरह की बननी चाहिए, क्या स्टैंडर्ड होना चाहिए उसका। वो एक 6+13 एपिसोड में उन्होंने बनवा के बता दिया। इसके लिए हम सब आर के लक्ष्मण और इस वक्त श्री कुंदन शाह और रवि ओझा को भी याद करना जरूरी है, और वो सारी टीम, राव साहब रिकॉर्डिस्ट, या जितने भी लोग थे, विनोद प्रधान, नीतीश रॉय, एक टीम थी, और मरहूम क्रिस्टीना खोटे जो इसकी प्रोड्यूसर थी। और आज फिर से हैट्स ऑफ प्रोडक्शंस में आपके सामने हम लोग पेश होंगे। कृपया इसे जरूर देखें, धन्यवाद।
नमस्ते, मैं भारती अचरेकर, मैं राधिका वागले। ये साल पूज्य आर के लक्ष्मण जी की बर्थ सेंटेनरी साल है, तो बहुत खुशी है कि इस साल में हम दोबारा वागले की दुनिया लेके आ रहे हैं। मुझे बहुत खुशी हो रही है और मैं समझती हूँ कि वो वहाँ से ऊपर से देख के हमको आशीर्वाद दे रहे होंगे, पक्का। इतना हम्बल आदमी था वो, मतलब हमने तो बहुत काम किया उनके साथ, जब हम लोग पहली दफ़ा 88 में कर रहे थे वागले की दुनिया, उस वक्त हमारी बहुत इंट्रैक्शन होती थी। स्टोरी सुनाने के लिए हम लोग साथ में जाया करते थे, अंजन और मैं, फिर वो डिस्कशन हुआ करता था, तो हमें उनका बहुत ज़्यादा स्वभाव पता चला कि कितने हम्बल और कितने, मतलब इतनी छोटी आवाज़ में बात करते थे, ज़रा भी आवाज़ उनकी चढ़ती नहीं थी, वेरी सिंपल पर्सन, व्हाट अ टैलेंट, एंड वी ऑफ कोर्स मिस हिम, बट उनकी लीगेसी वागले की दुनिया और कॉमन मैन दोनों ने जिंदा रखी है। तो हम उनकी आत्मा को भी शांति देते हैं कि वहाँ पे वो कुछ लिखे, कुछ नए वहाँ एक्सपेरिमेंट करें, और हमें आशीर्वाद देखिए नए वागले की दुनिया के लिए। थैंक यू।
सो जस्ट टू टेल द व्यूअर्स, मिस्टर अंजन श्रीवास्तव एक्टेड, वाज ही वाज इन द लीड रोल एज श्रीनिवास वागले, एंड मिसेस भारती अचरेकर वाज इन द लीड रोल एज राधिका वागले। So, I mean, once a technical glitch gets done, viewers will play the video again to you. So, yeah. We can
so,
go.
Yeah. So, by the time Fairy sort that problem out, I would like to ask you, how did this entire thing he conceptualized? Like, Nandu's uncle also said that he used to look into each and every episode, and he used to go and take care of everything. So, how he used to conceptualize this thing, and how was the process? Because he was working with, he had his full-time job also, right? So, how he managed all these things, and what was the process? How was the environment at home?
I still remember it used to be a Tuesday every week. From office, he would go to Tina Tote's house. And Kundan Shah, then Ajay Karthik, the script writers, you know, and of course the main cast like Anjan ji and Bharti ji would be there. And on the spot, he would create the episode. And
okay.
Today my episode is going to be about, you know, whatever the episode was. Say for instance, if the episode is about the Bagley family going on a picnic. Okay, so he will just keep the title, this is about the Bagley family going on a picnic. And he would actually enact the whole thing. And he was not very comfortable with the language Hindi. So he would show this in English and these people would audio record it and they were translating and they translated it into Hindi. So he would enact each and every cast, especially the main cast that is Anjanji and Bhartiji. And talk about the entire episode and the flow of the episode, sequence by sequence, as to how it would go. And then it was like a storyboard narration that he used to do, and also enact with expression. So that's the reason even the cast was around. So this is something which is, you know, very unique again, which is a very unique concept which Dad had conceived because he did not have time to sit and script it. But then.
The caption. So no. That was his, you know, a very unique thing.
And, yes.
That is why the originality of this Vagle Ki Duniya was, it was so original.
Yes.
I mean, people would immediately grasp the, you know, idea behind the entire episode. So,
yes.
That was great of him.
And another interesting thing is, you know, he made one line which I think is even, you know, embedded in G's mind, that going back, when there is a line given to you, you enact the line. The line is special, your body language has to show the expression of the line you're trying to narrate. So
I have one question related with this. So auntie, you and Nandu uncle, you both, did you get chance to witness this on the set? Like, did you get chance to visit him when he was working on the set and see all these things and experience it?
So what happened was, first Doordarshan had given, permission to do 6 episodes. They said, you do your 6 episodes and bring it and give it to us. So all the 6 episodes, of course, was completely conceptualized and the whole shooting was done. After that, Dad said, okay, show me all the episodes I want to see. And when he saw them, there was, you know, there were few things in 1 or 2 episodes, he was not very happy. And that one particular episode had to be redone all over again. And he said, until and unless that is complete, we are not sending it to Doordarshan, even if it means a couple of months more. And that meticulous he was. And after that, the second season of 13 episodes, when it came, he was very particular that once it was done, he was part of the editing part of it. He was part of, you know, whenever he would get time, he would go to the studio to watch the whole shoot and all of that. So I recall going there with Mom just once, you know, just to see the thing and meet the entire set. That's all I recall. But Dad used to be there very often. And right from that moment, he took complete charge of seeing every single take of the whole episode.
He was a perfectionist, and unless he was happy with the particular episode, he would not allow it to go to the Doordarshan. And in that, you know, the producer also agreed, because right in the beginning, he said that, I will select the I will select the cast, I will direct the thing, and nobody should interfere. So he was being told. So each and everything what he used to say used to be, you know, abide by every time.
Exactly. It was a beautiful blend of Lakshman, Ajay Karthik and Kundan Shah. In fact, they all complimented each other because each one came with their own expertise. And they blended together, they worked together, and they had such highest regards and respects for that. and they saw to it that whatever you know advice that he gave that they had to follow. And I think that's how magic was created, with all of them complimenting each other. They brought out an evergreen you know piece, which is remembered even today, and it has created a cult actually, you know.
This revival of this show Vagle Ki Duniya will definitely go a long way, because it is something different than, you know, the daily serials you see.
Yeah.
Because this has got a very intelligent satire, a very intelligent humor, a humor of a high quality. So I'm sure that his concept, you know, we were able to get it through. And JD, who is our good friend, he is really working very hard on it, and he has put in his heart and soul into it. I spoke to him today and he said that last 6-7 days I have not slept even for 2-3 hours. So I told him, Baba, our prayers are there, and this show is going to be a hit, and don't worry, and we are all there with you, and we wish you all the best. So this show will definitely go a long way because of the uniqueness of Mr. Lakshman's, you know, efforts going into this.
Yes, definitely. So, Fari, do you have any question?
Fari?
Fari, are you there?
Yeah, I'm here, guys. Yeah. So, let me ask you guys a question, which is, how easy or hard was this for others to work with an intelligent and perfectionist person like R.K. Lakshman? How hard is it?
He actually, it was an experience for each and every one of them. Even if I have to talk about Kundalika, who was a boy as far as direction was concerned, and Ajay Karthik as well. But it was a great experience for them, because something that came from Lakshman was very different, very innovative, very unique, because he didn't come from a background of a writer-director or an actor. But then he had all of that, and he had the biggest you know treasure in him, which was humor, and the creativity in him. It was a combination of all of that. So the thing was, just as I said, they complemented each other, they worked together, and you know there was no any kind of ego clash that they had. They all worked together in the interest of producing a good piece. So. I wouldn't call it was hard for them. I think they enjoyed the journey.
See, it Fairy,
thank you so much, ma'am.
Fairy, the thing is, once you surrender, then there is nothing hard. So, once you surrender to your wife, then there is nothing hard to manage.
So, I understand.
Yeah. ये सेंटेनरी ईयर है लक्ष्मण साहब का और क्या कहें आई मीन ही वाज द वॉइस ऑफ द कॉमन मैन ही वाज द क्रिएटर मैंने एक जगह पढ़ा था कि लक्ष्मण साहब ने ऐसा कहा है कि ही डिड नॉट क्रिएट द कॉमन मैन इनफैक्ट द कॉमन मैन क्रिएटेड लक्ष्मण साहब सो अ बिग सल्यूट टू वन ऑफ द ग्रेटेस्ट इलस्ट्रेटर greatest satirist, greatest humorist, greatest cartoonist. और ये मेरा सौभाग्य है कि मैं उन्हीं के creation में काम कर रहा हूँ. हम लोग बागले की दुनिया लेकर आ रहे हैं. तो again ये एक blessing है लक्ष्मण साहब का हमारी पूरी team के लिए. So thank you so much and long live R.K. Lakshman. Thank you.
Aunty, are there any memorable incidences associated with बागले की दुनिया which you would like to share?
Oh, definitely. Firstly, as I told you, every Tuesday he used to go to Tina Kote's house. Mm. And Dad, as you know, was a child himself. And he used to actually look forward to a Tuesday, because it was something which was away from his regular routine work, which was a very pressurized work. Right. Mm. So he actually looked forward to that. So we could see, we were able to visualize, and we were able to understand how happy he was that day. And then he would sit through the episode at Tina's place, and he would come home, have a dinner and was very particular that the entire family was at home during that time, particularly that day. And you know, she would in the morning itself say, after dinner, I will be narrating the episode that went through at Tina's place. All over again, he would sit with us post dinner, and whatever he did at Tina's place, the way he narrated the story, the way he enacted the whole episode, he would show it to us. And that was something fascinating for us, and we also equally looked forward to that evening week after week. So that's a memorable thing that, you know, I always like to share and talk about. So
R.K. Lakshmi, the common man. आम इंसान के सुख दुख हंसी मजाक और उनके सपनों को स्केच में प्रेजेंट करने वाला एक जादूगर. आई एम रियली फील वेरी ग्रेटफुल एंड लकी कि मुझे बागले की दुनिया में एक अहम कैरेक्टर प्ले करने का मौका मिल रहा है. थैंक यू सो मच आर के लक्ष्मण जी कि आपकी तरफ से हमें ये रिटर्न गिफ्ट मिला. बागले की दुनिया, नई पीढ़ी, नए किस्से. आपको 100th बर्थ एनिवर्सरी की ढेर सारी शुभकामनाएं. थैंक यू सो मच.
कॉमन मैन श्री आर के लक्ष्मण जी. सब ने शब्दों से लिखा लेकिन इनकी तस्वीरें बोलती थी. कॉमन मैन के इश्यूज को इन्होंने तस्वीरों से बताया. इनकी कलम नहीं तलवार थी. नाजुक से नाजुक मुद्दों को इन्होंने हंसी के माध्यम से जनता तक पहुंचाया. ये मेरी खुशनसीबी है कि मैं वागले की दुनिया का हिस्सा बन रहा हूँ. वो दुनिया जिसकी शुरुआत आर के लक्ष्मण जी ने की थी. मैं शिहान कपाही AKA अथर्व वागले उनको उनके 100th एनिवर्सरी पे उनको नमन करना चाहता हूँ.
So, what was the reaction of common people when this show came, and any memorable anecdotes from this, like from common people's side?
Yeah, as soon as the episode would get over, our phone would start ringing non-stop. And you know, in those days there was no mobile, it was just the landline, and the phone would start ringing non-stop. Even during the show we would start getting phone calls, and it never ended. It continued the next morning. And after that, it used to be, I think, on a Wednesday, if I'm not mistaken. After that, the newspapers went gallop. You know, media covered each and every episode. That is again something unique, because these days, you don't get each and every episode covered by media. And that too, not just one media. Media across used to talk about each and every episode in detail. There used to be interviews taken of Anjanji, interviews taken of Dad, and interviews taken of Bharatiji. And every media across the country used to cover it. And I have the whole cuttings with me, so I can speak for it, you know, in breath. So
the TRP of the show was the maximum in Doordarshan.
Yes.
And each and every person was eager and waiting for what will come in this episode. It was very, very famous, and the people were very happy because they used to see themselves, you know, just like one episode was there of, you know, the scrap material. The housewife always likes to sell the scrap material and, you know, get the money. Maybe it is a small amount, but that excitement is there.
Yes.
So that depicted the each and every common man's, you know, what is happening in their life. They used to see on the TV. And at times, you know, the wife used to say, "Dekho, dekho, tum bhi sikho. You also learn something from this." So it was a proper, you know, family serial, which everybody used to correlate with their own, you know, happenings in the house and all that.
In fact, I remember I watched one episode where there is something related with water, and he brought one big like like one big tub of like where he can store water, and he's storing water in each and every utensil he has in his house. Yeah. But someone tells
water
him
storage.
That
water storage
will be there.
Correct.
And many people related with that. I read few stories related with it, so that's why I asked this question.
So that was a unique thing, you know, where in his daily cartoons, he created the common man who was who was an epitome of for the mute spare, you know, the common meeple, yes. The mute spectators. He was there for the millions, the mute millions, right?
Right.
He represented the entire common man of the country. And the same thing he put onto the screen in Vagle Ki Duniya, actually a common man experiencing all of this, whether it's water crisis, a servant's problem, or, you know, wanting to buy a television, the excitement that the family has, or wanting to go for a picnic, and something to do with the child's, you know, football match or something in the school. So he picked on each and every nuances of a family life. And you know, created an episode out of it. That's what was interesting about it.
That was the uniqueness of this particular serial.
Yes.
And also, I think Shah Rukh Khan had appeared in his one of the episodes, which was the first time. I don't remember.
It was one of the first TV serial that he did, along with two others. And when he came to Mumbai to start his career as an actor, he started off in the TV industry. And Vagle Ki Duniya was one of the first that he did. And interestingly, that particular episode, is still very popular. If you click on Vagle Ki Duniya, that pops up as the topmost. And in fact, after the episode was done, Dad met Shah Rukh Khan and said, "Look, you're a great actor. You will go very far one day." And coincidentally, when Dad received Padma Vibhushan, Shah Rukh Khan received Padma Bhushan. So I remember we were all there in Delhi during that function. Shah Rukh Khan came running, fell at Dad's feet and said, "Your words came true, sir. Today I am on the top." So that kind of...
He had a sixth sense. He had also made a comment on Mr. Prime Minister Modi that, you know, his caricature, what he had made, that was the only caricature of a politician flashing a victory sign. So once I had asked him that how, you know, so he said that this guy will, you'd see the political circle cannot, we will not be able to ignore him. I mean, he has got that metal in him. So which also, you know, everybody is now witness to that. So he had a sixth sense and he had a vision. A big vision, and which used to come true.
Right, that's true. Mm. No doubt about it.
Uchira?
Yes. So he was a known cartoonist. So when he decided to work with a TV serial, how did his role as a cartoonist help him? And what were the common as well as different threads he discovered in this journey as a cartoonist and as a writer director?
So he often used to say, you know, for a cartoonist is like to create a cartoon in a single panel or multiple panel. This is like making a film. It's like being a filmmaker yourself. You got to create the script, you got to create the story, you got to create the props, you got to create the characters, you got to create the dialogue, you got to do everything all together and create a story. Right? So it is in short like making a film. So you actually, in one little frame, you know what all details that need to come, which a director typically looks at. And you know what all dialogues and the, you know, script that needs to come, which is looked after by a script writer, right? And you're also producing it because the whole thing is done by you. So actually the sketching part is the production part. So that's how he used to look at it. And I guess to become, to do something for a TV serial or even to make a film, I think, you know, being Lakshman what he was, you know, as far as creativity is concerned, I think it was not an issue or a big problem for him. So if he was, I think, given a film to do, he would have done a wonderful job too.
Yes, no doubt.
Very true.
And interestingly, he was very talented. His 10 fingers had talents. I know he was a good, he was very good in, you know, even doing any kind of craft work. He was very good in doing etching. He was very fond of, you know, plumbing and electric work. He used to get into the details of how plumbing works, like a pipeline. Or he used to get into the details of how a clock, he was very fond of opening a clock and repairing a clock. And very fond, very, very fond of technology. And that's why he always loved to be amongst youngsters who always had something new to talk to him about. And his curiosity, you know, that he had was immense. When he wanted to know everything. That's how you can see the diversity that he had and, you know, and how versatile he was in everything that he took up and did. He was a great singer too.
True, true.
All in one, all in one.
Yeah, he's a versatile personality.
Very versatile.
So, Fari, do we have questions yes. from the audience? So,
I have a question from Mr. Krishnan.
Hmm.
In which he asked, did Lakshman sir experiment with this media other than Vaglike Duniya? In which he says, which he is asking, did he do any other TV series in the TV format? Did he do anything other than Vaglike Duniya?
He kind of was partly involved in Malgudi Days, which is R.K. Narayan's thing. And purely because all the sketches that you see in Malgudi Days were again freshly made for Malgudi Days. And so the director used to actually come home and sit with him and take ideas from him based on the character that he sketched. Although the story was already there, written by R.K. Narayan, when it came to visualizing and picturizing, the sketches of that he made for Malgudi to be serialized, was done by him. So the director actually used to come and sit with him and discuss a lot. So in that respect, yes, he was a lot.
Okay. And I have another question, ma'am. Which year was Vaglike Duniya telecast? Because you told us most of us weren't even born when Vaglike Duniya was telecast. Can I know which year it was telecasted? Yes, ma'am?
1988.
1988, of course. I wasn't born by that time.
Yeah.
And, not even me.
And Ruchira was born a decade later, I think. And how much time did it take for conceptualizing it to telecasting it? So, because a serial is not like a film, they don't shoot the entire thing and then go telecast it. They shoot in parts.
Yes.
How much time did it take for conceptualizing to telecasting? How much time did it take for that? For the creating aspect?
Actually, right from the time Tina thought of doing something like this, you know, everybody sat together as to see how to bring all the material together to be able to do, to begin with these six episodes. Okay.
Mm-hmm.
And so although Dad used to narrate these episodes, they also, the director Kundan Shah and Ajay Karthik, to understand a little more, you know, in order to create the entire body. So, all of this went back and forth for almost 1.5 years.
Mm-hmm.
And then the shooting, you can say, another couple of months. So I would say close to 2 years. It took about close to 2 years, right from the conceptualized stage. As far as Dad was concerned, he did it at one go. There was no issue.
Okay.
But the rest that had to be done and all of that together, totally with taking permission from Doordarshan, and the process took about 2 years.
Okay. So after the process, how many episodes was totally telecasted, ma'am? How many episodes was Lakshman sir a part of?
The first six episodes came together one after another, and it became so popular, it became a public demand. And so immediately Doordarshan commissioned for the next 13 episodes.
Mm-hmm.
And after this was completed, after the 19 was completed, from Doordarshan, it moved to Star Channel, Star TV, where they produced another set of 13 episodes. So, totally, Dad has done 13 plus 13, 26 plus 6, 32 episodes.
Amazing. Thank you. Thank you so much, ma'am. Back to you, Ruchira.
Yes. So now I want to understand from you, Auntie, how did it all start again? Like, tell a story behind the revival of Vaglike Duniya.
Oh, okay. I will tell my bit and then Nandu will tell his bit.
Yes.
So, let's all give a, you know, lift our own collars to say kudos to Lakshman Legacy. It all started because of us. Mm-hmm. Okay, so the Lakshman Legacy, conversing with the common man, that we have been doing to celebrate the 100th birth anniversary, of course, went across people, you know. I used to get a lot of responses, and one of it, of course, was JD. JD is Jamnadas Machidia, who is the producer of the new series Hardik Duniya, under his production house, Hats Off Production. He called me one day. He texted me and said, I want to talk to you. So he called me and he said, I've been getting your messages about all the brilliant things that you're doing. It is so overwhelming to see that you're doing so much and paying tribute to Lakshman on his 100th birth anniversary. I would also like to be part of it, and I want to do something. Okay. And I said, why not you come, you know, on board on one of the episodes. We will take you on. He said, of course, I'll do it because I've done RK Lakshman Ki Duniya. I've got a lot of experience that I would like to share. But in this year, I want to do something for him. So that is how I said, I have these 19 episodes. Bagli Ki Duniya. Let us remember Lakshman and bring his memory back and, you know, show these 19 episodes, bring it to the current generation. Lakshman Legacy is all about carrying his legacy forward, particularly for the current generation who do not know much about him. And why not we do this? So his instant reaction was, of course, we can do that, but why not do something even bigger and pay a big tribute to him? And I said, okay, what will you do? What can you do? So he said, let's create something like a new series based on his concept, based on his creativity, based on what he had in mind. The seed that he sowed, okay, is become a plant. Let us take it forward and, you know, make it a tree and create branches out of it. And so he said, just give me a couple of days, I'll get back to you. Believe me, that's the way it all started. And
see, actually, I'll tell you, because when he called Usha and he said something of Lakshman Legacy we want to do, so immediately Usha said Bhagle Ki Duniya. So he was little surprised whether he has said or Usha has said, because JD had called Usha for Bhagle Ki Duniya only. So it was a message, you know, from Mr. Lakshman, that in my birth anniversary, I mean centenary, you do this particular serial. So it all happened in such a short time. Within 5 days, the entire thing was conceptualized by JD and we signed the agreement and everything. So it was literally God sent or Lakshman sent message, and it all happened very fast. So even in the JD's this thing also, video also, he has talked about this. So Fairy will run that video, and you know, he has, because he being a director and an actor, he could explain very vividly, whereas we can't. So you see the video, he has said it very nicely, and the facts.
Yes. So my next question was, I think Fari has any question, right?
I have a question. The thing is, the old episode had a lot of essence in it. Of course, I watched it after you told me this thing was going to happen. I went and watched all the episodes. Now, how are you going to transfer the essence of this old version to the new version without Lakshman sir?
So we have, you know, who's carrying it forward. We have Anjan ji and Bharti ji, Mr. Anjan Srivastava and Mrs. Bharti Achwekar, who have been part of the earlier episode, who have, you know, gone through that journey along with Lakshman, Lakshman directing them. And, you know, they have understood, you know, the essence, his nuances. And they are the pillar actually in the new series, along with Sumit Raghavan and the others who are going to come in. And as Nandu clearly said, JD being an actor himself, he has understood this. And there's a very good writer-director, Atish Kapadia, who's on board. So आई एम श्योर द एसेंस ऑफ व्हाट डैड हैड क्रिएटेड, एज आई टोल्ड यू, ही सो द सीड एंड यू नो ग्रू द प्लांट इनटू अ ट्री एंड नाउ द ब्रांचेस आर कमिंग आउट. सो आई एम श्योर, आई मीन द ब्रांचेस विल वेयर द फ्रूट फॉर ऑल ऑफ अस टू एंजॉय दिस शो डे आफ्टर डे मंडे टू फ्राइडे.
See, Fairy, the structure is same. You see, if there is a foundation of a building, so you build the foundation, then you build two floors, and then you extend it to another three floors. So the structure of the serial will remain the same. And what they have, you know, seen in the episodes, the same structure will be there with the grievances of the common man, then what happens in day-to-day life. And Mr. Anjan Srivastav is the grandfather, and Mrs. Radhika, I mean, that is the Bharti, she is the grandmother. So, all it is a continuation, and the entire concepts, what Mr. Lakshman used to use, they will be using it. So it will be an extension, and further three floors will be added, and then it will go up to 100 floors of the building.
Yes, with the 100th year, with that's
good.
So it's basically a gap, bridging the gap of the 80s generation.
Yeah, and the new generation.
Where the problem space are almost similar. I mean, there's no change in that, but on different grounds. Yes. And it's like a nostalgic journey, you can say, down the memory lane.
Yes.
A memorable recall and an emotional connect.
So, and it is said, Wagle ki duniya naye kisse.
Yeah,
naye kisse means naye peedi, naye kisse. Matlab the peedi is the
new
son and the grand, I mean the daughter-in-law and the children. So, naye kisse aayenge, wohi jo pehle aate the. So you can, if even if nobody has watched the old serial, they'll be able to watch that essence in the new serial.
So we all are looking forward to this.
Yes.
Yeah. And Uncle, so my last question to you is, how will you describe R.K. Lakshman in one word?
Miracle man is the word for him. I mean, there is no miracle up to now. Born like him.
Yes.
So he is a miracle man.
Uncle, you have prepared something for him, isn't it? So would you like to present it?
Pardon?
You have prepared something for him,
yeah,
right?
Yeah, yeah, yeah. I have prepared a remix for him, remix of a Hindi song.
Yes. So we would like to listen to that.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. One minute. Chalo, I'll just see. I had written it, but I remember it. Pal pal dil ke paas tum rehte ho. पल पल दिल के पास तुम रहते हो, जीवन मीठी प्यास ये कहते हो, पल पल दिल के पास तुम रहते हो, हर शाम आंखों पर तेरा ब्रश लहराए, हर रात यादों की बारात ले आए, हर शाम आंखों पर तेरा ब्रश लहराए, हर रात यादों की बारात ले आए, मैं थाम लेता हूँ तेरी खुशबू आती है, एक महका महका सा पैगाम लाती है, मेरे दिल की धड़कन भी तेरे कार्टून गाती है, पल पल दिल के पास तुम रहते हो। लक्ष्मण जी की जय।
Thank you so much. It was wonderful and creative at the same time. So, before we move, like before we end this program, Auntie, would you like to say something?
Yeah, firstly, very nice song, Nandu. Yes. It is like saying that he lives in each and everyone's heart and forever, because he is an evergreen person and his works are also evergreen. So, that's very thoughtful rendition that you have done, and thank you so much.
And thank you.
Yeah. So, audience, sorry we couldn't play the video, all the videos that we have collected as a live stream, but this is going to be, put up on YouTube and our all our social media platforms. There is going to be a video of Anjun ji, and he is going to be basically talking about his experience in the new series, and about Lakshman, and also Bharti ji, that is Bharti Achlekar, the new, the junior Wagle, Sumit Raghavan, and the two grandchildren, and of course, J.D. Jamnadas Machidia. Although J.D.'s video was shown on his birthday, it was already there, but please watch it again, and so this is for those of you who never got to watch it then. Please watch it. Those of you who already watched it also, please watch it again, because that's going to really tell you how emotionally and excited like a child he is about this. And so are we, all of us. Very, very excited. And we are all looking forward to tomorrow 9 p.m. when the first episode is going to be screened on Sony Sub at 9 p.m. And it's going to be screened Monday to Friday, 5 days a week. 9 p.m. prime time. We would like all of you, without fail, tune in to Sony Sub every single day, Monday through Friday, and experience and remember Lakshman for what he did for us and what he has left behind for us. That's the biggest tribute I think all of us can give him and remember him on this 100th birth anniversary. Thank you.
And all, it is my request that all of you see, whoever is watching the show or the entire India should see this serial with the wife and children. And I am sure the wife and the children will love you more than before. So, please see the serial from tomorrow 9 p.m. Okay?
Yes, right. What you said is right, because in the late 80s, when the first the original Wagle film, the whole family used to sit and watch. And I think we are bringing back that experience back into the drawing room of each and every home across the country, that we want the entire family to sit and watch. It is a family drama meant for the family, and it's like bringing the family together during dinner time.
And this also shows the bond between the husband and wife, the bond which was there between Wagle and his wife. That bond was very strong, and he used to always work on that to show that bond. And so that is why I am saying that if your wife is not loving you enough, then she will start loving you.
And also grandparents, the bond between grandparents and grandchildren. So yeah, it's going to be a family of grandparents, parents, children, that's grandchildren. So it's going to be a very exciting, emotional journey that all of us are going to start all over again from tomorrow. What we left in the 90s, we are continuing it 40 years later.
Yes. Right.
Chalo, all the best to us and to all of you.
Yes.
And yeah.
See you later.
Thank you.
Bye yes.
Bye. Birthday. Happy birthday to me. आज तक कभी किसी ने
कहीं सुना है सामने से कोई बंदा आके बोलता है मेरा बर्थडे है और हैप्पी बर्थडे टू मी और बड़ा खुश होता है, कोई वजह थोड़ा खिसका वाला बेवकूफ है। जब आदमी बहुत खुश हो जाता है ना तो थोड़ा बहक जाता है और तभी वो कभी कभी थोड़ा बेवकूफ लगता है। तो मैं आज शायद आपको वैसा लगूं, आई एम वेरी हैप्पी, हैप्पी बिकॉज आई एम मेकिंग दिस वीडियो ऑन माई बर्थडे, आई एम मेकिंग दिस एपिसोड ऑन माई बर्थडे, जो कि मैं डेडिकेट कर रहा हूं आर के लक्ष्मण जी को। और आर के लक्ष्मण जी को सिर्फ ये वीडियो नहीं, ये पूरा शो जो हम बना रहे हैं वागले की दुनिया, जो कि उनका क्रिएशन था, वो जो हम कर रहे हैं वो ऐसे ऐसे वक्त पे हो रहा है कि हमारे में सेंटा क्लॉज का कॉन्सेप्ट ऐसे नहीं है कि आपको सेंटा क्लॉज गिफ्ट देते हैं। तो मेरे लिए आर के लक्ष्मण जी दो बार सेंटा क्लॉज बने हैं। मैंने कुछ साल पहले आर के लक्ष्मण की दुनिया करके एक शो बनाया था, अच्छा चला था, पर अभी जो करने जा रहा हूं तो कैसे हुआ उसकी कहानी बड़ी इंटरेस्टिंग है। फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल बिग 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 थैंक्स टू उषा लक्ष्मण जी, नंदू गुप्ता जी। मैं ऐसे ही हम लोग एक मिडिल क्लास फैमिली पे शो बनाने की सोच रहे थे और सब टीवी के जो बिजनेस हेड है नीरज व्यास, उन्होंने मुझे कहा कि ऐसे हम लोग कहानी ऑलमोस्ट फाइनल करने पे तैयार एक शो पे बैठे थे और उन्होंने बात बात पे एक आइडिया बोला था जिड़ी वागले की दुनिया, एक रेफरेंस के तौर पे उन्होंने मुझे बोला था। और मैंने ऐसे ही उषा जी के साथ मेरी बहुत मैसेजिंग, एक हफ्ते में वो एक प्रोग्राम के बारे में मुझे कहती रहती थी, तो मैं उस दिन मैंने उनको फ़ोन किया, मैसेज और फ़ोन। तो उषा जी ने सामने से मुझे कहा कि जेडी ये वागले की दुनिया करो ना, मेरे को समझ भी नहीं आया कि मैं बोला वो बोले। तो उन्होंने कहा मेरे पास 19 एपिसोड जो है वो किए थे पुराने, वो है और उसका कुछ करते हैं। मेरे मन में आया कि वो क्यों करे, हम कुछ आर के लक्ष्मण जी डिजर्व समथिंग फार बिगर, समथिंग फार बेटर, है ना, उषा जी का ही आइडिया था। तो मैंने बोला हम कुछ नया करें, तो बोले कैसे करेंगे, बोले मुझे कुछ वक्त दीजिए, मैं एक दो लोगों से बात करता हूँ चैनल लिए, और हियर वी आर। ये मिड नवंबर की बात थी, दिसंबर में सेट बनना शुरू हो गया, बहुत मेहनत करी हमने, उषा जी ने, नंदू जी ने, सबने मिलके, नीरज चैनल, सब टीवी शो, सब सोनी, पर ये सारी हमारी मेहनत के पीछे मैं एक ही बात देखता हूं, एक संकेत ऊपर से, वो था आर के जी का कि 2021 यानी कि उनका सेंटेनरी ईयर है और उस सेंटेनरी ईयर में कुछ बहुत बड़ा होना चाहिए और वो है वागले की दुनिया। और बस देखते देखते कुछ तभी तो तय नहीं था, कहानी बनना शुरू हुई, आतिश को बताई बात, तो आतिश ने तुरंत दो तीन कहानी हमने बैठ के बातें करी, फिर चैनल पे गए और हमने जाके प्रेजेंट किया, ये मैजिक की तरह शो बनने लगा। और अभी तो मेन मैजिक कि हम लोग सोचते करते करते उतने में सुमित राघवन को, वही जो मैंने कहा उस शो के बारे में मिलने वाले थे, मिले भी, और सुमित को देख एक दो तीन चीजें, एक वागले की दुनिया है, सुमित के डन डन, एक दूसरे कोई बात नहीं हुई हमारी। आज के दिन का कॉमन मैन मिडिल क्लास सुमित राघवन को आप देखोगे तो मैं कह रहा हूं आपको मैं बहुत ज्यादा खुश दिखूंगा मैं हूं। और फिर अंजन जी द ओरिजिनल श्रीनिवास वागले और उनकी राधिका भारतीय आचार्य कर, उसमें परिवा प्रणति, सुमित यानी कि राजेश वागले की वाइफ, दो बच्चे, पूरी सोसाइटी का कॉन्सेप्ट आप देखिए, मैंने तो देखा हुआ है अभी, यू विल लव इट, यू विल लव इट। और ऊपर से आर के लक्ष्मण जी बहुत आशीर्वाद दे रहे हैं, चीजें उन्हीं की तरह बनती जा रही है, उन्हें अगर आज के दिन में वो बताते तो ऑफकोर्स वो तो बहुत बड़े जीनियस थे और हमारा सद्भाग्य है कि हम वो चीज कर रहे हैं, तो वो भी खुश होते ऐसा हमने शो बनाया, इसलिए मैं बहुत खुश हूं। और मेरे लिए सबसे बड़ी बात है 8 फरवरी से ये शो शुरू हो रहा है, आज 5 फरवरी मेरा बर्थडे है, अभी इस उम्र में बर्थडे गिफ्ट तोहफा एक्सपेक्ट करना, हम सेलिब्रेट भी नहीं करते, हाँ बच्चे करते हैं, पर आज मैं बच्चे से भी बड़ा बच्चा हूँ, इतना खुश हूँ क्योंकि इस साल की बेस्ट बर्थडे गिफ्ट मिली है कि मुझे ये आरके लक्ष्मण जी के क्रिएशन वागले की दुनिया का ये सीरीज ये टीवी शो बनाने का मौका मिला है। मैं इस बात को लेकर बहुत इमोशनल हो जाता हूं कि ये शो जब आता था उसमें एक एपिसोड भी था इसी तरह का कि लोग दूसरों के घर पे जाते थे, इतने लोगों का टीवी नहीं था, तो मैं दूसरों के घर पे ये शो देखता था। आज मैं इस शो का निर्माता हूं और मैं एक वन ऑफ द की पर्सन जो निमित्त बन रहा है कि करोड़ों लोगों के घर के टीवी में जाके ये शो दिखेगा, तो इससे बड़ी ईश्वर की कृपा क्या। तो मैं ईश्वर का बहुत बहुत आभारी हूँ, आरके जी का बहुत आभारी हूँ, उषा जी, नंदू गुप्ता जी, सोनी सब, नीरज व्यास और सभी लोग जो इससे जुड़े हैं, खासकर मेरे जो बिजनेस पार्टनर है, को प्रोड्यूसर है, राइटर है आतिश कपाड़िया, और पूरी टीम का, अंजन श्रीवास्तव, भारती जी, सुमित राघवन, परिवा प्रणति, जयेश पाटिल, बच्चे जो कास्टिंग में, और बहुत सभी लोगों का बहुत बहुत आभारी हूँ और बहुत खुश हूँ। और इसी खुशी के साथ बच्चे की तरह कह रहा हूं कि आप लोग अगर ये देख रहे हैं 5 फरवरी को, तो 8 फरवरी 9 बजे अपनी डायरी में नोट कर लीजिए, ये मिस मत कीजिएगा। ये दुनिया बड़ी मजेदार है, बहुत खुश हो गया। जिस तरह मैं अब खुश देख रहा हूं फिलहाल, आप उससे भी ज्यादा खुश होकर हंसेंगे।
So, guys, as we have already mentioned that this entire month will be a Vagle Ki Duniya month. So, in our upcoming episodes, we will be meeting all this, different people from Vagle Ki Duniya, including Anjan ji and the new Vagle, that is Sumit ji, then director, writer, producer, all of them. So, please watching this space for more updates. We will announce our next speaker and our next episode soon. Each time with each conversation, we are learning a lot about RK Lakshman and all the new things, new perspectives, and this is really overwhelming. So today, cheers is to natural acting, to the responsibility, to the perfection, to the clarity of thoughts. Today, cheers is to the one who takes complete charge of things, to the one who puts efforts unless he is satisfied. So today, cheers is to memory, cheers to uniqueness, cheers to revisiting memories, and cheers to the combination of humor and creativity, to the passion. So today, cheers is to the child inside us, to the experience, to the common man, and to the creator of common man, to the miracle man, as Nandu uncle said today. So we all are looking forward to meet you again. And if you are not following us yet on our social media platforms, then please follow us because your support means a lot to us. And as I already mentioned, please keep watching this space. And today it wasn't possible for us to show all the videos to you. So we will be posting them as soon as this session gets over. So go and watch them. You will understand the connection of this people with the RK Lakshman and the Vagle Ki Duniya. So
finally, cheers to Ruchira.
Yes, the entire team of Lakshman legacy.
Right.
So bye bye, take care, see you again.
Thank you.